Good morning, Rayfield. It is Thursday. Let's start with our Thursday morning prayer. Remember, every day God takes you by your hand and says, no matter how difficult the path you tread, I will never leave your side.
It's another great day at Rayfield, and it's Thursday. And of course, we know that today is our day that we participate in our dance class and our exercise classes with Coach Al, Miss Shanalee, and our piece work team, Miss Francesca and Mariana, who have been performing our exercise classes for us. We have just finished with a few self-love activities, and now we're going to talk about annually taking care of our teeth, taking care of our pedicure, manicure, all of those things we've talked about, getting a body massage, maybe monthly. We talked about daily, weekly, monthly, and now we're going to talk about those things that we need to do annually to take care of ourselves. There I am getting that pedicure, manicure, massage, all those wonderful pictures, healthy snacks that we've taken a part in, going to the salon and getting your eyes done and your nails done and your feet done. Well, guess what, folks? Annually, there are some very, very serious things that we must do to take care of ourselves. Now, let's talk daily. Our exercise might consist of running, walking, just very simple things. We've talked about people we can trust in our lives, things that we can do to relax. Walking the dog, housework. Although we don't think, or running, we don't think of those things as relaxing, but I do. And then other relaxation is people that I can trust and talk to. I can always talk to a parent, God, a caregiver. I can pray. We've talked about things that we can do to relax our body, like prayer, mediation, good food. Although we don't want to overeat, we're doing our taking care of ourselves and our self-loves. But I'm thinking of the conversation with God, the morning prayer that we have every day. Those small things that we can do to relax our mind and our body. In our annual review that we all do every year, there are so many great things that we would like to include. That just leads me to believe that we're going to have to do another video on annual review. So during the week, we've talked about what we do daily for our self-care. We've talked about what we do weekly. Now we've talked about what we do monthly, and now it's annual. What are those things we do annual? And it's so, so great, because once we get started talking about these things, we just want to do so much more. In our annual review, we always start with our health care when it relates to self-care. So we know that annually, everybody in the whole wide world gets a physical, at least annually. We go to our healthcare practitioner or our general practitioner, our doctor, and we get our physical. The doctor takes care of our blood pressure, of all of our vitals. They weigh us. They take a look at our weight in comparison between last year and this year. You might get a mammogram or some type of pap smear to just review everything naturally and physically. Your dentist might want to do something different in terms of what's happening with your dental care. You might need an implant. You might need a tooth removed. You might need a cavity removed. And they look at that annually. What has taken place with your health during the year, and what needs to change for the upcoming year? So an annual review in terms of health care is just a total overview of your health. And if you are taking any type of medication, which most everybody is, they take a look to see how those medications have worked and if they also may or may not need to change. So moving on from healthcare and self-care, we've talked about self-care in terms of loving ourselves. Let's talk a little bit more about the annual review. And I am positive that Miss Joan in the main office is laughing because she does everybody's annual review. And I really should be interviewing her for this part of our video. So that lets me know I'm coming back to the annual review. I like to look at things academically because everybody knows that Dr. Carter is a teacher and she looks at education, always education. Loving to learn, and every day we learn at Rayfield. So I look academically to see what are we going to improve academically. Some of us might want to improve our handwriting. And remember at Rayfield, we do handwriting every day. We pass out those forms with your name and your personal information on it. And you guys do the handwriting exercises to improve your handwriting. You might want to improve your socialization skills. And many of us have that on our record as a part of our goal. Learning how to get along with others as we socialize and as we participate in different activities at Rayfield and in the community. We might want to improve our attendance. Say, for example, we only come to school 2 or 3 days a week. And you know what? In order for me to improve my handwriting, my socialization skills, some of those other things, I think that I want to go to school just one more day. Maybe I'm only going 3 days now, maybe I'll go 4. Or maybe the days that I'm home, now that we have virtual school, I'll participate in virtual school so that I get that extra added push to help me academically. Then, I also academically want to be more positive. And I mean that in more than one way. My whole outlook about learning, my whole feeling about learning, how I feel about learning. I want to be more positive about learning. Now that we are virtual and we're doing virtual school and we are learning so many more things in technology, I like that. I like using my phone, my Android, my tablet. I like learning how to go on YouTube and Facebook and TikTok. All those little things that you have learned this year. And I shouldn't say little things, they're great things. It's been great for me to learn those things as well. I am enjoying learning those things academically. Now let's move on a little bit. How about learning or improving annually our time management? How we use our time. Now you know me, I am always on a to-do list. Look, right here in front of me, a whole to-do list of things that I'm gonna tell you while we're on this video. I love my to-do list. And what I love more about the to-do list is putting that check mark that says I have accomplished what I set out to accomplish. Time management for me means that I'm making it through my day and I'm doing those things that are important for the school, for you, for me, and for everyone's learning. Time management. And that's in terms of schedules and checklists. I also put down time management as it relates to health. Now, what am I thinking about there? Drinking our water. And I can always reach right in front of me and find water. What does time management have to do with water? Well, guys, it takes time to drink all of this water. So I even have a reminder on my phone that reminds me every hour, it's time to drink a little bit more water. And that's how you get through your water in a day. It's very, very important. We have people who are in hospitals because they are dehydrated, not drinking enough water. That has a lot to do with time management. Okay? Might also want to add your trips to the bathroom. And I know that sounds kind of silly, but I have to tell you something. When you drink a lot of water and you don't go to the bathroom on time, It causes bladder problems. And then later on in life, when you try to get to the bathroom, sometimes you don't make it and you might wet yourself. And although that sounds kind of creepy, sorry I have to mention it, it's time management. Drinking your water and going to the bathroom. Time management. Okay, let's move on a little further. Communication. Annually, I would like to improve communication. How do you do that? I'd like to be more clear when I tell you something. When I'm sharing a story, or when I'm sharing an activity or an event, or even a video, I want it to be clear. I want you to clearly understand what I'm sharing. So therefore, I want to effectively communicate a little bit more. I want to be more direct. I want to share the goal with you of my communication. And I want to share with you in a friendly way. So I want friendly communication. I want full communication. I want potential obstacles and barriers to not be there when I'm communicating. So another annual goal is better communication. The opposite of that kind of is listening. I want one of my annual goals to do a better job of listening. When I'm communicating, when I'm sharing, I also want to get the point that the other person is sharing with me. Or if I'm in a seminar, or if I'm taking a class, or even watching a video like this one, I want to listen more so that I understand what is being shared with me, right? I talked about handwriting. I talked about spelling. I talked about grammar. I talked about listening and communication. For me, that whole piece comes together in terms of listening. That's another goal. Now, you might want to set some new goals annually. And we all know, let's go back to Miss Joan in the main office, that when we get our goals, we set a new goal for the upcoming year. It might be that we just add to the goal that we have. It might be that we just change it a little bit. We tweak it, as we call it. We might want to subtract some things from that goal because we learned it. We mastered whatever that key term was. And I want to add something else in its place. For example, I'm doing such better job in time management with my water, with my drinking, with my this, with my that, time management. So I'm going to add something more to that part of my goal. I am going to add, let me see, I want to learn to count money better. So this year, I'm going to add counting my coins and counting my money to my goal. That might be an improvement on my goal as far as I'm concerned. I want that new skill added to my goal. I also want to do a better job of being happy with sharing criticism. I'm trying to say that in a way that doesn't offend anyone. I want to be more open-minded. When someone says to me that I did something wrong, I don't want to immediately be defensive. I want to say, okay, how can I do that better? That's being more open-minded. I want you to get that point because I'm going to come back to it. Maybe not in this video, maybe in the next one, but I'm coming back to being open-minded and receiving criticism in a positive way, receiving positive feedback. All right, and last but not least, my annual summary, annual review, annual improvement has to do with my weight. So I'm going all the way back to the beginning to health. When we think about our new clinic at Rayfield, everybody came into the clinic. I hope you've been there. If you haven't, let's get over there to Miss Kelly, and we weighed in. So one of the first things that we worked on was our weight and our health management. So we weighed ourselves. In terms of annually, we want to look at whether or not we gained weight. this year or lost weight this year. So we can look at our charts in the main office and see how much did I weigh last year and how much do I weigh now? Have I gained weight or have I lost weight? And of course, we are praying that we lost weight or we didn't change at all. Maybe we stayed the same weight. So that's an annual goal, that we make sure we maintain a healthy weight. We took our measurements. We measured our arms, we measured our legs, we measured our stomach. We took our measurements in terms of our feet, and we're gonna go into the clinic. We'll do a little bit of videos on that so you can see how that works and what's been going on over there. And we're also going to be receiving our annual certificates. I don't know if you guys remember last year, we have our progress ceremony. So our progress ceremonies are coming up and we're going to receive our annual certificates that go in our progress ceremony envelopes, and we're gonna take them home. And so also annually with our certificates, one of the things that we're gonna add at Rayfield this year is that not only are the staff going to do CPR, the students are going to learn how to do CPR. I think it's important that we all know these things. We're also going to talk very, very seriously about HIPAA because it's important. I've had students, staff, everybody say to me, you know, it's not nice when they talk about me. I get it. So therefore, we're all going to train on HIPAA. And for me, that's talking about each other. We want to learn more about that. We're always learning. And last but not least, we're going to do more training in terms of medication. Why? I hear so many times, you guys tell me, I don't want to take medication. I don't want to take a COVID shot. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. Well, let's learn. Why are we doing that? What's important about our medication? How do we make an informed decision about our medication? Last but not least, that's my final comment. How do I make an informed decision about medication? Well, guys, that's my annual review. I went over health, I went over academics, I went over time management, communication, listening, new goals and skills, and my annual clinic review. It's been wonderful. It's a great day at Rayfield. We're learning every day. It is Thursday. It's Thinking Thursday, and we are so happy. We are so excited. One thing that I didn't tell you, we have all staff been COVID tested, and we are COVID free. I am so excited about that, and I am so proud of all of you. We went through the CVS drive-through clinic. We all got our results, and we are all clear. I am so excited. I'm so proud of every one of you, and let's continue doing the good work here at Rayfield. We are Rayfield Strong. Have a great day.
Good day, Rayfield family. Here are the weather forecasts for this week. Monday, partly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 82. Wind south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Monday night, clear skies with a few passing clouds. Low 74. Wind south at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tuesday, mixed clouds and sun with scattered thunderstorms. High 82, wind south at 10 to 20 miles per hour, chance of rain 50%. Tuesday night, partly cloudy skies, low 73, winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy skies, high 82, winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Wednesday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 74, winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Thursday, sunshine along with some cloudy intervals. High 82. Winds south at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Thursday night, clear in the evening, then increasing clouds with some scattered thunderstorms after midnight. Low 67 degrees. Winds south-southwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Chance of rain 40%. Friday, a shower or two possible early with partly cloudy skies in the afternoon. High 74. Winds west-northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Chance of rain 30%. Friday night, a few clouds from time to time. Low near 55. Winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, partly cloudy skies. High 73. Winds north at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Sunday, partly cloudy. High 74. Winds east northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Monday, partly cloudy. High 76. Winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. This is your weather report for this week. Keep your umbrella handy. Keep your hats intact. Because if it flies, I'm not responsible. Anyway, have a blessed week. See you later.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed? At the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, we're so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
go to the 23rd Psalms. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley and the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Just a testimony about beside myself. Tell me you've been so. I see you, Betty Jackson. Been so good. Good to see you, girl. You've been so good. You've been so. Been so good. Hallelujah.
Doctor. I have a right to go to church. I have a right to remain disciplined. I have a right to community outings. I have a right to talk. I have a right to education. I have a right to refuse treatment. I have a right to privacy and dignity. I have a right to make money. I have a right to exercise. I have a right to see my records. I have a right to own possessions. I have a right to receive services. I have a right to no discrimination. I have a right to know this law.
We'll be learning more about Groundhog Day. Groundhog Day is celebrated annually on February 2nd. On this day, people use a groundhog to determine the length of the current winter season and the possible early onset of spring. This weather prediction is dependent on the day's conditions. 6 more weeks of winter are on the way if sunshine causes the groundhog to see its shadow and go back into hibernation.
Sorry, folks! 6 more weeks of winter.
While clouds and gray skies prevent the appearance of the groundhog's shadow and result in spring's speedy arrival. The period between the winter solstice and spring equinox has been important throughout history. For instance, the Celts anticipated spring by celebrating the pagan festival of Imolc. Some people believe Imolc then evolved into the Christian holiday of Candlemas, which celebrates the presentation of Jesus at the temple and falls on the 2nd of February. It was during the Middle Ages that Europeans began to rely on the shadows of hibernating animals as an indication of incoming weather. During the 1700s and 1800s, German immigrants brought this belief to the United States and selected the groundhog as the chosen animal in Pennsylvania. The first official celebration of Groundhog Day occurred in that state's city of Punxsutawney in the late 1880s, when several businessmen and groundhog hunters of the Punxsutawney Groundhog Club watched the groundhog observing his shadow. Though this holiday has since spread across North America, the biggest annual Groundhog Day celebrations remain in its place of origin, where a groundhog dubbed Punxsutawney Phil predicts the weather. Tens of thousands of people and countless media outlets visit the city during early February to participate in festivities that include music and food. For the actual ceremony, Phil is relocated to Gobbler's Knob by his handlers, made up of a group of top hat and tuxedo-wearing individuals called the Inner Circle. Though the Punxsutawney Groundhog Club maintains that Phil is right up to 90% of the time, studies have shown the number is actually closer to less than 40%. This has done nothing to quell people's interest and fascination with the groundhog's forecasts. In fact, the holiday was given an even bigger boost following the successful 1993 comedy Groundhog Day.
This is one time where television really fails to capture the true excitement of a large squirrel predicting the weather.
Set in Punxsutawney, the film also led to Groundhog Day being used as an expression for experiencing situations over and over again.
Do you ever have deja vu, Mrs. Lancaster?
I don't think so, but I could check with the kitchen.
From movies and TV shows to children's toys, Phil and Groundhog Day have appeared in pop culture on numerous occasions. Though Groundhog Day is mostly observed in North America, other countries practice similar traditions. Some American states use other animals instead of the groundhog. Meanwhile, the Canadian city of Wyarton in Ontario is home to a popular festival based around a groundhog named Wyarton Willie. For more great videos, be sure to
amen, amen. Woke up this morning with my mind stayed on Jesus, stayed on the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. God has smiled on us once again. He has blessed us to be able to open our eyes to experience this day we have never seen before and we will never see again. And it's not because we have been so good, is because God is good. Not just some of the time, but our God, he is good all the time. And because he is good all the time, we will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in our mouths. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Wednesday. No, it's Thursday. Thursday, February 4th, 2021. It is time for a conversation with God. Good morning to all of our prayer warriors who are joining us today. We thank God that he's blessed us to see this Thursday and given us another opportunity to glorify him. Hopefully you have had a blessed week thus far. Things are going well with you. If they're not going well, you hang in there. You hang in there. We know it will get better. It will get better. And we just hope, trust, and pray to all of our prayer warriors on fire for the Lord, doing what we do best, praying for folks, encouraging folks, being the light that we have been called to be in these dark times, being the salt of the earth, using our influence through our good works to glorify God who is in heaven. Again, we just thank everyone for joining us for this time of prayer, this time of fellowship with the Most High God, and even fellowship by faith with one another. I continue to praise God for each and every one of you who join us every morning at 7:30 a.m. for this very special time. I believe in the power and the privilege of prayer. I believe prayer works. And I truly believe that you all believe the same thing. You believe that prayer works. And it's because of that that we have assembled together in this virtual house of prayer just to talk to the Lord, to let him know what is on our hearts and our minds. I know this morning, I believe we got a slow connection. So I see on YouTube, it's kind of slow. I think on Facebook, it's kind of slow. But nevertheless, as I always say, if you can hear me, that's a good thing. As long as the audio isn't lagging around, you all can still hear me. You can still fellowship with me and join with me in prayer by faith, even by just hearing my voice this morning. And I tell you what, man, you never know. You all hear me say this all the time. You never know what kind of connection you're going to get when you are dealing with Wi-Fi and internet and relying on other folks to get you connected to the world. But nevertheless, we just thank God for each and every one of you for your patience, and hope, trust, and pray that your time with me and with others this morning in this conversation with God will be a blessing. This morning for our meditation, we are going to Psalms 56. And I just want to get one verse, and that's verse number 3. Psalms 56, and the verse is 3. If you're watching this, write that in the comment section. Psalms 56 and verse number 3. The psalmist says, "What time I am afraid, I will trust in thee." In other words, when I am afraid, I will trust in you. When I am afraid, I will trust in you. For this morning's meditation, I want to give to you the subject, I trust God. Say it, I trust God. God, no matter what is going on around me, no matter what is happening in the world, no matter how things may look, at the end of the day and always, I trust God. Family, let me ask you a question. What are you worried about? What are you worried about? This week, we have been focusing on the healing power of God. And not only God's ability to heal our physical ailments, but our emotional wounds as well. We have been looking at the psalmist that says that he heals the brokenhearted, he binds up their wounds. And we've been looking to God to heal those emotional hurts that we often deal with, the things that we struggle with, even mentally. We believe that God has the power to make us whole. And to be whole means to be healthy, not only physically, but to be healthy mentally and spiritually. And so we've been praying and asking God to give us the strength and to heal us of our brokenness, those emotional wounds that we have been struggling with, that many struggle with in their lives. We started with prayer for those who are dealing with bitterness, that God will help them to let it go. And then we talked yesterday about those who are struggling with grief and sorrow, asking God to comfort those individuals and let them know that everything is going to be all right because God has grace for our grief. This morning, in this lesson, I want us to focus in on anxiety and worry. Anxiety and worry are things that can often paralyzed individuals because they are based on fear. You find people who are worried about a lot, who are anxious, who are dealing with anxiety that comes out of fear. They are afraid of something. They are afraid of the worst. Oftentimes, fear is just false evidence appearing real. We conjure up in our minds the worst thing that could possibly happen. And then our body reacts to that. Even though the danger may be real that we are facing, that the challenge may be real, but how we respond to that is our choice. That's up to us. We can either respond in fear or we can respond respond to the danger with faith, trusting God, having the assurance and knowing that what God has promised, he will and has the power to fulfill. The cure for anxiety and worry is to trust God. You hear me? The cure for worry, the cure for anxiety is to trust God. Now, I'm going to say this from the onset that I truly believe that as human beings, because we're in this flesh, that worry and fear are going to be things that are common. We all worry from time to time about this, that, or the other, and it's something that we constantly struggle with. But again, the only way to overcome that struggle with worry, anxiety, and fear is by learning to trust God. And so when we look to the scripture, we understand that, you know, trusting God, it ain't easy. You know, why can I or why should I trust God? My question would be, why not trust God? When you look at God's word, you know, God gives us so many reasons why we can be confident in his power to do what he said he will do. When we go to Matthew chapter 6, we look at verses 25 through 34, a text that many of us no doubt are familiar with. Jesus reaffirms why we can trust God and why we ought to be free from fear, worry, and anxiety. Matthew chapter 6, beginning at verses 25, going down through verse number 34. Why should I and why can I trust God? Jesus said, therefore I say unto you, take no thought. In other words, don't worry about your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is not the life more than meat and the body than raiment? Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are you not much better than they? The first reason why you and I can trust God is because you need to know you matter to God. You matter to God. He's concerned about your well-being. You are valuable in the sight of God. You are the apple of God's eye. You matter to God. You are created and his image and his likeness, the only being on this earth created in the image and the likeness of God. You can trust God because you matter to God. And he says here, Jesus said here, if God takes care of the birds of the air, don't you know he's going to take care of you? And he goes on to talk about the flowers. He says in verse number 27, not only do you matter to God, verse 27, which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? Next reason why we can trust God is worrying doesn't help. It actually takes away from us, not only emotionally, but physically. Worrying and anxiety, it affects our health. And so it doesn't help us. Worrying is not beneficial. So I should trust God because God, I matter to God. I should trust God because worrying does not help. And then he goes on to say, and why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you, that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? You matter to God. All he needs you to do is to trust him. And then he goes on to give us another reason why we should trust him. Therefore, take no thought, verse 31, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father, is important. Heavenly Father, father, child, relationship. You should trust God because God has a relationship with you. You have a relationship with God. And most importantly, when you look at the words of Jesus, for your Heavenly Father knows that you have need of all of these things. Why should you trust God? Because God knows exactly what you need. And because he knows, and because you matter to him, he's going to make a way. All you have to do is just trust him. So Jesus reaffirms this, gives us the instruction, the cure for overcoming fear, worry, and anxiety. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for tomorrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. Why are you worried about tomorrow? Why are you worried, period? God's got everything under control. I know it's going to happen. I know, you know, the situation may look dire. The situation may, the danger may be real. The challenge may be real. But God's power is greater than any storm you and I will ever encounter. You all remember in Mark chapter 4, verses 35 through 41, when those disciples were on that boat and the boat ran into a storm and the water and the rain was getting onto the boat and the wind was blowing and it was rocking the boat and Jesus was in the boat asleep. He was in the hinder part of the boat asleep. But the disciples, looking at the wind and looking at the rain, they were panicking, look at all this stuff. And then they ran down and woke Jesus up. Jesus, don't you care that we are perishing? We're dying up here, and here you are down here asleep. Don't you care about us? Jesus got up, and he rebuked the wind and the waves, and he said, peace, be still. This is our prayer this morning for those of you who are struggling with an anxious heart, who are worried about this, that, or the other. We want to pray that God will speak and give peace to your troubled heart this morning, your anxious heart, your fearful heart, that God will settle your spirit so that you won't be anxious, that you will just learn to trust in his promises, to have faith that God is real and that he rewards those who diligently seek him. Have faith and trust and know, be confident and sure that what God has promised, he has the power to fulfill. Doesn't matter how big the problem is, it does not change or impact the power of God. Let's learn to walk by faith and not by sight. Don't let your heart be troubled about, you know, the health problem or, you know, what the doctor has said, the word of the doctor. Focus in on the word of God. Don't worry about how dangerous and how, you know, this virus and all those things. Protect yourself, do what you need to do to stay safe and stay out of harm or whatever the case may be. But ultimately, God cares about you. You matter to him. Worrying is not going to solve any problems. It's not going to make you feel any better. As a matter of fact, if you're not careful, that worry is going to lead to anxiety, and that's going to begin to affect your health. Trust God, because he knows exactly what you need, and he has promised to provide for all your needs. I trust God. Whenever I am afraid, the psalmist said, I will trust in you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, again, we rise on this day. Thank you for another opportunity that you've given unto us to be able to assemble together in your presence as your children. Father, we gather before you this morning, first of all, with thanksgiving on our hearts. We recognize that truly we have been blessed beyond measure. You watched over us last night. You protected us from all harm, hurt, and danger. And you gave us one more sunny day. And we thank you for that. We thank you, Father, for choosing to love us, for choosing to give us the air that we breathe, for choosing to give us the roof over our head, the food on our table, the clothes on our back, the transportation that we have, the jobs and the resources that we have. We thank you, Father, for choosing to give us those blessings, because we realize we have not earned them, Father, by our own works, but it's because of your mercy and your grace. And because of that, Father, we say thank you. We thank you so much for your mercy and your grace that you continue to show towards us, the compassion that you show us, the patience that you show towards us in spite of our shortcomings and our flaws. Thank you, Father. And Father, as we come before you this morning, we realize that there are many whose hearts are troubled right now. They're worried about the things that are going on in their lives and in this world, Father. They're dealing with anxiety, Father, and other issues. Their hearts are anxious and troubled. They are fearful, Father, because of the things that they see and the things that they hear. Father, settle their hearts. Please, Father, speak peace into their hearts right now. Settle their hearts. Give them that peace, Father, that passes all understanding. You told us in your word, Father, that we are to be anxious for nothing. We're not to worry about anything, but we are to pray about everything. So we pray for those individuals right now, Father, who are worried about their children, worried about their marriage, worried about their health, worried about their finances, worried about the things that are going on in their lives in this world. They're not able to sleep. They're not able to function. They're not able to be healthy. Father, help them, Father. Help them to understand that you have everything under control. And if there's anyone that we can trust right now, we can and should trust you. Because we know, Father, we, as your children, we matter to you. We are valuable in your sight. We are the apple of your eye. Why? Because your word tells us so. We also know, Father, that worrying doesn't help us in any way. It has no benefit, Father. It harms us rather than hurt us. And Father, help us to trust you, because you know all about us and you know exactly what we need, and you promise to provide for us to meet our every need. So Father, I just pray again for all those whose hearts are troubled right now, who woke up this morning, instead of their mind being on Jesus, it was on their troubles, on their problems, on their finances, on their family, everything else but the Lord. But we pray and ask in Jesus' name, Father, that you will center their hearts and their minds back on you, back on your word, back on your promises, back on your power, back on your presence, knowing that whatever you bring us to, you will bring us through. Bless us as we go through this day, Father. Give us the strength, the wisdom, and the courage that we need to meet every challenge, to not only meet every challenge, but to overcome the challenges and the temptations that we will face on this day, being confident in you, Father. We pray for those who are in need of healing in their physical bodies, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, whatever the case may be, make them whole right now, Father. Restore them back to a normality of health and strength as only you can. Help them to serve, help them to be a shining example how you heal those who trust in you. And Father, those who are just struggling to make ends meet, they don't know where their next bill is going to come from or how their bill is going to get paid, Father, but help them to remember the words of Jesus, that we are to seek you first, your kingdom and your righteousness, and everything that we need will be provided. So help us, Father, when things look rough, to turn to you and to always keep you first, to trust you in spite of what is going on, Father, to trust you in spite of how things may look, just to trust you, Father. And we know when we do that, you will give us that peace that passes all understanding. Bless all of our prayer warriors as we strive to be a blessing to others through the privilege and the power of prayer. Help us be ever mindful of the people around us, those who are hurting, those who are just dealing with the various issues of life. Help us to be a light to them. Help us to be able to point others to you, so that they too can have their hope and their confidence in you. Father, bless us as we grow through this day. Continue to bless this nation, our government, our president, our vice president. Shield them from all harm, hurt, and danger, and help them, Father, to accomplish the things that are right in your sight, Father. And we pray that their hearts will be in your hands, Father. Please, Father, watch over us, watch over our families, and keep us until we meet again. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, family, don't forget, I trust God. It doesn't matter what the problem is. It doesn't matter how big the problem is. God is bigger than any problem that you and I will face, because he loves us, because he cares, because we matter to him, because worrying doesn't help, because we know he knows everything that we need. We can and should trust God. It's not the end of the world unless it's the end of the world. So go forward today. Have a blessed day. Remember, everything's going to be all right because God is on your side. Y'all have a blessed day.
Also the students at home. Today we're going to go through the bachata dance again, and then we're going to learn a new move for the salsa dance. And after that, we're going to choose a song so we can have fun with it, okay? So welcome back. As I said, I am Coach Shanalee, Coach Shani, however you want to call me. And today, Chris want to be my host again. So Chris will be helping me, and today we have Garth as a student.
Yay.
We have Carla, say hi.
Hi.
We have Cindy. Say hi, Cindy. We have Janet. Hello. Hi, Janet. We have Jasmine. This is a new student today. So we have Jasmine with us. Say hi, Jasmine.
Hi.
We have Katrina with us. And and we have Chris. So students, you guys got to meet one more student today. Her name is Jasmine. We're going to have fun. Remember, our dance class are supposed to be fun. So no worries. Don't stress. If you have questions, just ask. If you miss a part, just ask or wait. We're going to repeat it, okay? No need to stress. Just have fun. Okay, remember to have a bottle of water with you. If you need some water, just drink some water. If you need to rest for a bit, that's fine too. It's supposed to be fun. Okay, so as always, we're going to start with a warm-up. Okay, so guys, take your spots. Spread out a little. Spread out a little. Okay, Chris, is that your spot? Okay, perfect. Okay.
Professor.
As I said, we're going to start with a warm up.
I'm staying.
You know, this is the remix.
Chris, you're standing from the scene. Okay. As always, we start with our neck. Rolling it in the left direction. Not too fast, so you don't hurt yourself. It's supposed to be a warm-up. And then let's change direction. We're going to the right. Roll your neck to the right. Not too fast, so you don't stretch your muscle. Okay, make sure you don't hit anyone, but stretch your arms. Stretch your arms, and let's go circles to the front. Big circles. Stretch the arm muscles, because we're going to use our hands today, our arms. And as we go, we make the circles smaller. Okay, and then we go the same way, but to the back. Say it again. It hurts? Okay, big circles. And then as we go, we make them smaller. Okay, let's do high knees. High knees. No worries. It's okay. Do it however you can. If you can go too high, you go the highest you can. To the left.
Oh God.
Hallelujah.
Stretch to the right. Stretch to the left. Stretch to the right. All right. So right now we will continue. Right now we will continue and we will go through the bachata dance as we did 2 weeks ago and last week.
Well, okay, I have a question.
Okay.
You have to dance right before we start doing dance.
Say it again.
I forgot how to do it.
No problem, no problem. I'm going to show it again. Then we're going to do it together. Okay?
Right.
So we will start with the basic steps. Jasmine, as I know, you didn't do the bachata dance with us. So I'm going to do it for you guys.
Okay.
And then you guys just watch me, and then we do it together, okay?
Okay.
So basically...
I know how to do it, so I ain't worried about it.
Okay, no problem.
Yes, Professor Christie.
Okay, so basically, it's pretty simple. It's a kind of three-step move. So you do one, two, three, tap.
Okay.
One, two, three, tap.
Okay.
Pretty simple, okay?
Okay.
But with a song, it's going to be speeded up a little. So we're going to do one, two, three, step. One, two, three, step. Okay?
Okay, yeah.
Listen. So,
thank you.
So, do you guys remember a little how it was? Carla, do you remember?
I remember.
Sorry?
I wasn't here.
You wasn't? Oh, Carla, you wasn't here either. Okay, so you guys should pay even more attention, okay? So, basically, again, it's going to be left, right, left, step. Right, left, right, step. Okay?
Okay.
Left, right, left, step. Right, left, right, step. Left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step. Okay, do it with me, Katrina. Do it with me. So we are going to start with the left leg, and we're going to the left. So, wait, let's do it. One, two, three. Left, right, left, step. Now we're going to the right, starting with the right leg. So, right, left, right, step.
Okay.
Okay? So now we're going to the left again, starting with the left leg. Okay?
Okay.
Left, right, left, step. Okay? And we're going to the right, starting with the right leg. Okay? Right, left, right, step. Now we're going to do the same thing, but there's no break in between. So left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step. Left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, let's do it. Starting with the left leg, we're going to the left. Okay? One, two, three. Left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Let's do it again. Left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step.
Okay.
You guys got it?
Yep.
Carla, you got it? Okay. Katrina, you got it?
Can you do it again?
Sure. Let's do it again. So we're going to start with the left leg, going to the left. No break in between. Okay? One, two, three. Left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step. We're going to do it again. One, two, three. Left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step. Okay, maybe when I put the music, you guys are going to feel it a little more. So I'm going to put the music. We're going to do the same thing, okay? Let's try it. Okay, for the students at home, remember starting with the left leg, going to the left, left, right, left, step, right, left, right, step. But on the music, it's going to be speeded up a little more, okay? Let's do it. Left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Carla, you're doing a good job. Of course, Janet, Cindy, Garth, and Chris, you're doing a good job too. But since they're new and since they are needed a little more directions, I put more emphasis on them, so they're doing a great job. Don't you guys think so?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm just a
okay. Students at home, I'm sure you guys doing a good job too. You like it, Jasmine?
Yeah, I like it.
Are you enjoying?
First time.
Of course.
Thank you.
I'm so glad you like it.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's do it one more time, and then I'll teach you guys the front, back, front, back.
I was going to say same thing.
Say it again?
I'm going to say the same thing.
Okay.
Chris. I'm going to do this again.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to do front, back.
Exactly.
I was going to tell you that, but you didn't. I was going to use all that.
Awesome. You're good, Chris. You're a good host.
So we're going to do that.
Uh-huh.
Back,
exactly. Okay. So let's do left, right, left again. So I want to make sure you guys got it.
Yes, ma'am.
So we can switch to front, back, front, back.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Excuse me,
ma'am. Uh-huh.
Okay. Since he's new, who go in front first and who go behind us?
Say it again.
Okay. Since Jasmine is new,
uh-huh.
Who go in the front and who go behind the person? The same way, or just
that's fine.
Oh, well,
uh-huh, that's
okay.
Fine. Okay.
Good question.
Yes. Good question. Yes. Every question is a good one. So if you have questions, just ask. Okay.
Chris, just tell something. Tell them something.
She forgot.
Okay, students.
Go back.
Let's do it again. Let's do it again. Because if you know the right, left, it's easier
for the front, back.
It's easy for the cross. It's very simple. Okay?
Right,
let's try the left, right again.
Left.
Okay? Remember, starting with the left leg, going to the left, left, right, left, tap, and then going back to the right, left, right, tap. Okay?
Yes,
then you're going to add
you.
A hip and the arm. You're definitely a good host, Chris.
You have to get it. You're an A for everything.
Okay, let's do this.
Zero. Gone.
Okay, are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Students at home ready?
Yeah.
I'm sure they are.
She will.
Okay. Okay, it's coming. One, two, three, tap. Katrina and Carla, we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to add the hips and the arms. Okay? It's supposed to be like this. 1, 2, 3, tap. 1, 2, 3, tap. Okay? We're going to add a little more sauce to it. Okay?
Okay. Ingredients.
Right. Ingredients. The spices.
Okay, I'll try
it.
You're going to be like this.
Uh-huh. Good job, Katrina. Oh, look at you.
She just got out of bed.
I'm probably. See how you do it?
Let's add some flavor to it. Students at home, let's add some flavor to the dance.
She turns red now.
Let's do it.
Hot sauce in the house.
We're going to add some
spicy.
hips and some arms. It's gonna be fun.
Okay. Yeah, I'll try that.
Okay.
We're gonna need this. Let's go.
Okay.
I like the moves.
Okay. I'm glad you do. Okay. We're going to just do the left right. Step. 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 Chris, can you please go a little backwards? Yes. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, tap. 1, 2, 3, tap.
Oh, one.
Okay.
Two,
three, same thing. Three. Just you're going to the front and to the back.
Okay.
Okay.
Do it again.
Yes. I will do it again. Okay. When we're going to the left and the right, we're starting with the left leg, right?
Okay.
Let's do the same thing. We're starting with the left leg, but going to the front. Okay? 1, 2, 3, tap. 1, 2, 3, tap. So it's left, right, left, tap, right, left, right, tap.
Okay?
Let's do it again. Left, right, left, tap, right, left, right, left.
Okay.
Okay, you got it?
Yep.
Katrina, you got it? One more time. You got it?
Can I help myself?
Sure. Let's do it again. Left, right. Left, tap. Right, left, right, tap. Okay? Janet, you got it? Chris, you got it?
I know.
You sure?
Okay.
Jump in.
Okay, start. You good.
I'm like this.
Okay, let's do it again. To the front. Starting with the left leg. Left, right, left, tap, right, tap, right, tap. Let's do it again. Left, right, left, tap, right, left, right, tap. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's speed it up a little more. Remember, as the sun's going, it's going to be a little more faster. So we're going to the front to the back without break in between. Okay?
Okay.
Let's do it. 1, 2, 3. Left, right, left, tap, right, left, right, tap. Left, right, left, tap, right, left, right, tap. Left, right, left, tap. Right, left, right, left. Okay?
Yes.
Let's add a song. Okay? Morning. Students at home, you got it? Remember, left leg, starting with the left leg, going to the front. So left, right, left, tap, right, left, right, tap. Okay, let's try it with a song. Y'all are ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm ready.
We go into the front. Okay, let's go. Left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left. What's the problem?
Valeria, I don't
exercise.
Your back hurts? Huh?
No, my knees don't hurt.
Your knees?
I've been told you, you see him when I told you. You see him when I told you my knees hurt, you said, oh, okay.
Oh. So is it because of the dance?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's go, Coach Kelly. Okay, students, we are back. So sorry. So Katrina had a little bit pain in her knees. So if you have any pain, no worries. Just sit, rest for a moment. Remember, it's going to be fun. It's supposed to be fun. So if you have any, like if you hurt anything, no worries. You can just sit and then you can continue with us, okay? No problem at all. Okay, so let's continue, guys. Let's repeat the front and back again.
Front, two, three, four.
Okay.
Then four times a time, Michelle.
Okay.
Let's
repeat the front and back again.
Michelle. So we're going to go one, two, three.
I like that name.
Exactly.
One, two, three, and then go.
Okay.
I like that name.
Thank you so much, Jasmine. You have a beautiful name, too.
Thank you.
Sure. Okay, let's try it again, guys. Front, back, okay? Take your spots. Okay, let's do this. Okay, we're going to do front, back, okay? Starting with the left leg, okay? Let's go. Okay.
Chris is demonstrating
the fun music.
Oh,
okay, we're going to finish with the fun music.
Okay.
That's the one that Chris is demonstrating.
Follow the leader. You liked it? You guys want to follow the leader, right?
I can try.
Okay.
I'll drink a shot.
Guys, we don't hit each other. Let's be nice. Okay. So let's try the crisscross again. Okay. So the crisscross is pretty simple. Almost like okay, that's fine. Okay, so it's almost the same as left and right. So you just do left, right, left, cross, right, left, right, cross, left, right, left, cross, right, left, right, cross. Okay, you guys got it?
Yes.
Okay. It's pretty simple, almost like the left, right, left, right. The only thing you add is a cross at the end. Okay? Let's try it. Left, right, left, cross, right, left, right, cross. Left, right, left, cross, right, left, right, cross. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Let's try it.
Oh,
let's try
it
in the music. Okay. Students at home, left, right, left, cross, right, left, right, cross.
Yeah.
If we don't know how to do it,
As Chris said, if you don't know how to do it, just watch us, and then you do it with us later, okay? Okay?
Just watch us.
Okay, let's do this. You guys need to go to the restroom. You guys don't need to ask me. Okay?
Yes.
No need to ask to go to the restroom. Just go. Do your thing. Come back. Nobody has to know what you're going to do.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, perfect. So you guys are super good. You guys did the left, right,
the cha-cha dance.
Ooh, I love the cha-cha dance. I love the cha-cha dance.
You guys did the left, right, perfect.
Yes, thank you.
Crisscross, perfect.
Yes.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. Okay, students at home, what do you guys think? What do you guys think about Katrina, Garth, Carla, Cindy, Janet, Jasmine, and Chris? They're good, right? They're pros, and you guys are too. Okay? So, I'm super proud of you guys too. Remember, it's supposed to be fun. Left, tap, right, tap. Left, cross, right, cross. And then go into the front, left, tap, right, tap to the back. Okay? So, basically you can say now you can dance bachata because you know the basic steps. Right now the only thing you need is a partner. Remember guys, bachata, we dance it with a partner, but because of COVID, we're doing it by ourselves, okay? Guys, you're there?
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, we're here.
Okay.
We're all sleeping.
Okay. Yes, it felt like you guys are sleeping.
No, I'm not. I'm okay.
Okay.
It's my first.
So
I'm just enjoying it.
Of course.
I'm just enjoying it.
I'm super glad you are. Thank you for having me. Thank you for being in my class.
Yes, you're welcome. Anytime.
Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. Do you guys want a quick break? Quick to get some water and some air.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, students, we are back from the break. I hope you guys had some water, got some air. Right now, we're going to have a little more fun. We're going to do the follow the leader.
Follow the leader, my bad.
Yes, we're going to do the follow the leader. And students, the way it works, so we're going to do the follow the leader. So each and every one of you is going to be the leader for a moment. Like, we're going to just follow the steps you are going to show us.
Oh, okay.
Okay?
Like, for example, the dance that we did is part of that.
Yeah.
Okay? So, let's do this.
Who's going first?
Take your spot.
Who's going first?
You want to go first? Okay.
Uncle Chris in the house.
Chris is going to be first. Showing us the moves.
Hey.
Okay, are you guys ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. Okay, take a spot. Okay, follow the leader. You just do whatever Chris is doing. Okay? Okay, who wants to be the leader now? Okay, let's do whatever Jasmine is doing. Guys.
Okay.
Come on. So fast.
So
We're going to do the cool down. And then we will finish the class, okay? It's important to cool down since we had a high intense exercise doing the follow the leader. So we're going to do the cool down. So we will be ready to go for either going back to the class, you're going to back to work. You're going to be cooled down and relaxed, okay? We're going to do the cool down, guys. Please take your spots.
Okay.
For us to do the cool down. Okay?
Please,
where are you? Go. Where are you?
Go.
We want me up there. I'm
got
it.
Got it.
Okay, guys. Your hands high. Bring them down. Can we do? Bring them high again. Bring them down. Remember, take a deep breath. One more time, remember to breathe.
Really?
One more time, guys, remember to breathe.
This is not the most movie I've ever seen.
Okay. Okay, let's stretch to the left. Come back to the center, stretch to the right, go back to the center, one more time to the left, one more time to the center, good man, once again to the right. Okay, now stretch your arms. And we're going to do to the left of the body. Let's do the left one. Let's switch. Put your right arm like here, and then the left one goes on the elbow. And then we do the same thing. Left one here, right one on the elbow.
Good morning, Rayfield. It is Thursday. Let's start with our Thursday morning prayer. Remember, every day God takes you by your hand and says, no matter how difficult the path you tread, I will never leave your side.
It's another great day at Rayfield, and it's Thursday. And of course, we know that today is our day that we participate in our dance class and our exercise classes with Coach Al, Miss Shanalee, and our piecework team, Miss Francesca and Mariana, who have been performing our exercise classes for us. We have just finished with a few self-love activities, and now we're going to talk about annually taking care of our teeth, taking care of our pedicure, manicure, all of those things we've talked about, getting a body massage, maybe monthly. We talked about daily, weekly, monthly, and now we're going to talk about those things that we need to do annually to take care of ourselves. There I am getting that pedicure, manicure, massage, all those wonderful pictures, healthy snacks that we've taken a part in, going to the salon and getting your eyes done and your nails done and your feet done. Well, guess what, folks? Annually, there are some very, very serious things that we must do to take care of ourselves. Now, let's talk. Daily, our exercise might consist of running, walking, just very simple things. We've talked about people we can trust in our lives, things that we can do to relax.
Walking the dog, housework. Although we don't think, or running, we don't think of those things as relaxing, but I do. And then other relaxation is people that I can trust and talk to. I can always talk to a parent, God, a caregiver. I can pray. We've talked about things that we can do to relax our body, like prayer, mediation, good food. Although we don't want to overeat, we're doing our taking care of ourselves and our self-loves. But I'm thinking of the conversation with God, the morning prayer that we have every day. Those small things that we can do to relax our mind and our body. In our annual review that we all do every year, there are so many great things that we would like to include. That just leads me to believe that we're going to have to do another video on annual review. So during the week, we've talked about what we do daily for our self-care. We've talked about what we do weekly. Now we've talked about what we do monthly, and now it's annual. What are those things we do annual? And it's so, so great, because once we get started talking about these things, we just want to do so much more. In our annual review, we always start with our health care when it relates to self-care. So we know that annually, everybody in the whole wide world gets a physical, at least annually. We go to our healthcare practitioner or our general practitioner, our doctor, and we get our physical. The doctor takes care of our blood pressure, of all of our vitals. They weigh us. They take a look at our weight in comparison between last year and this year. You might get a mammogram or some type of pap smear to just review everything naturally and physically. Your dentist might want to do something different in terms of what's happening with your dental care. You might need an implant. You might need a tooth removed. You might need a cavity removed. And they look at that annually. What has taken place with your health during the year and what needs to change for the upcoming year? So an annual review in terms of health care is just a total, total overview of your health. And if you are taking any type of medication, which most everybody is, they take a look to see how those medications have worked and if they also may or may not need to change. So moving on from healthcare and self-care, we've talked about self-care, self-care, self-care in terms of loving ourselves. Let's talk a little bit more about the annual review. And I am positive that Miss Joan in the main office is laughing because she does everybody's annual review. And I really should be interviewing her for this part of our video. So that lets me know I'm coming back to the annual review. I like to look at things academically because everybody knows that Dr. Carter is a teacher and she looks at education, education, always education. Loving to learn, and every day we learn at Rayfield. So I look academically to see what are we going to improve academically. Some of us might want to improve our handwriting. And remember at Rayfield, we do handwriting every day. We pass out those forms with your name and your personal information on it. And you guys do the handwriting exercises to improve your handwriting. You might want to improve your socialization skills. And many of us have that on our record as a part of our goal. Learning how to get along with others as we socialize and as we participate in different activities at Rayfield and in the community. We might want to improve our attendance. Say, for example, we only come to school 2 or 3 days a week. And you know what? In order for me to improve my handwriting, my socialization skills, some of those other things, I think that I want to go to school just one more day. Maybe I'm only going 3 days now, maybe I'll go 4. Or maybe the days that I'm home, now that we have virtual school, I'll participate in virtual school so that I get that extra added push to help me academically. Then, I also academically want to be more positive. And I mean that in more than one way. My whole outlook about learning, my whole feeling about learning, how I feel about learning, I want to be more positive about learning. Now that we are virtual and we're doing virtual school and we are learning so many more things in technology, I like that. I like using my phone, my Android, my tablet. I like learning how to go on YouTube and Facebook and TikTok, all those little things that you have learned this year. And I shouldn't say little things, they're great things. It's been great for me to learn those things as well. I am enjoying learning those things academically. Now let's move on a little bit. How about learning or improving annually our time management? How we use our time. Now you know me, I am always on a to-do list. Look, right here in front of me, a whole to-do list of things that I'm gonna tell you while we're on this video. I love my to-do list. And what I love more about the to-do list is putting that check mark that says I have accomplished what I set out to accomplish. Time management for me means that I'm making it through my day and I'm doing those things that are important for the school, for you, for me, and for everyone's learning. Time management. And that's in terms of schedules and checklists. I also put down time management as it relates to health. Now, what am I thinking about there? Drinking our water. And I can always reach right in front of me and find water. What does time management have to do with water? Well, guys, it takes time to drink all of this water. So I even have a reminder on my phone that reminds me every hour it's time to drink a little bit more water. And that's how you get through your water in a day. It's very, very important. We have people who are in hospitals because they are dehydrated, not drinking enough water. That has a lot to do with time management. Okay? Might also want to add your trips to the bathroom. And I know that sounds kind of silly, but I have to tell you something. When you drink a lot of water and you don't go to the bathroom on time, it causes bladder problems. And then later on in life, when you try to get to the bathroom, sometimes you don't make it and you might wet yourself. And although that sounds kind of creepy, sorry I have to mention it, it's time management. Drinking your water and going to the bathroom, time management. Okay, let's move on a little further. Communication. Annually, I would like to improve communication. How do you do that? I'd like to be more clear when I tell you something. When I'm sharing a story, or when I'm sharing an activity or an event, or even a video, I want it to be clear. I want you to clearly understand what I'm sharing. So therefore, I want to effectively communicate a little bit more. I want to be more direct. I want to share the goal with you of my communication. And I want to share with you in a friendly way. So I want friendly communication. I want full communication. I want potential obstacles and barriers to not be there when I'm communicating. So another annual goal is better communication. The opposite of that kind of is listening. I want one of my annual goals to do a better job of listening. When I'm communicating, when I'm sharing, I also want to get the point that the other person is sharing with me. Or if I'm in a seminar, or if I'm taking a class, or even watching a video like this one, I want to listen more so that I understand what is being shared with me, right? I talked about handwriting, I talked about spelling, I talked about grammar, I talked about listening and communication. For me, that whole piece comes together in terms of listening. That's another goal. Now, you might want to set some new goals annually. And we all know, let's go back to Ms. Joan in the main office, that when we get our goals, we set a new goal for the upcoming year. It might be that we just add to the goal that we have. It might be that we just change it a little bit. We tweak it, as we call it. We might want to subtract some things from that goal because we learned it. We mastered whatever that key term was. And I want to add something else in its place. For example, I'm doing such better job in time management with my water, with my drinking, with my this, with my that, time management. So I'm going to add something more to that part of my goal. I am going to add, let me see, I want to learn to count money better. So this year, I'm going to add counting my coins and counting my money to my goal. That might be an improvement on my goal as far as I'm concerned. I want that new skill added to my goal. I also want to do a better job of being happy with sharing criticism. I'm trying to say that in a way that doesn't offend anyone. I want to be more open-minded. When someone says to me that I did something wrong, I don't want to immediately be defensive. I want to say, okay, how can I do that better? That's being more open-minded. I want you to get that point because I'm going to come back to it. Maybe not in this video, maybe in the next one, but I'm coming back to being open-minded and receiving criticism in a positive way, receiving positive feedback. All right, and last but not least, my annual summary, annual review, annual improvement has to do with my weight. So I'm going all the way back to the beginning to health. When we think about our new clinic at Rayfield, everybody came into the clinic. I hope you've been there. If you haven't, let's get over there to Miss Kelly and we weighed in. So one of the first things that we worked on was our weight and our health management. So we weighed ourselves In terms of annually, we want to look at whether or not we gained weight this year or lost weight this year. So we can look at our charts in the main office and see how much did I weigh last year and how much do I weigh now? Have I gained weight or have I lost weight? And of course, we are praying that we lost weight or we didn't change at all. Maybe we stayed the same weight. So that's an annual goal, that we make sure we maintain a healthy weight. We took our measurements. We measured our arms, we measured our legs, we measured our stomach. We took our measurements in terms of our feet, and we're going to go into the clinic. We'll do a little bit of videos on that so you can see how that works and what's been going on over there. And we're also going to be receiving our annual certificates. I don't know if you guys remember last year, we have our progress ceremony. So our progress ceremonies are coming up, and we're going to receive our annual certificates that go in our progress ceremony envelopes, and we're going to take them home. And so also annually with our certificates, one of the things that we're going to add at Rayfield this year is that not only are the staff going to do CPR, the students are going to learn how to do CPR. I think it's important that we all know these things. We're also going to talk very, very seriously about HIPAA because it's important. I've had students, staff, everybody say to me, you know, it's not nice when they talk about me. I get it. So therefore, we're all going to train on HIPAA. And for me, that's talking about each other. We want to learn more about that. We're always learning. And last but not least, we're going to do more training in terms of medication. Why? I hear so many times, you guys tell me, I don't want to take medication. I don't want to take a COVID shot. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. Well, let's learn, why are we doing that? What's important about our medication? How do we make an informed decision about our medication? Last but not least, that's my final comment. How do I make an informed decision about medication? Well, guys, that's my annual review. I went over health, I went over academics, I went over time management, communication, listening, new goals and skills, and my annual clinic review. It's been wonderful. It's a great day at Rayfield. We're learning every day. It is Thursday, it's Thinking Thursday, and we are so happy, we are so excited. One thing that I didn't tell you, we have all, staff, been COVID tested, and we are COVID free. I am so excited about that, and I am so proud of all of you. We went through the CVS drive-thru clinic, we all got our results, and we are all clear. I am so excited. I'm so proud of every one of you. And let's continue doing the good work here at Rayfield. We are Rayfield Strong. Have a great day.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming,
whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, we're so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
as we go to the 23rd Psalms. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley and the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Just a testimony about beside myself. Tell me you've been so. I see you, Betty Jackson. Been so good. Good to see you, girl. You've been so good. You've been so. Been so good. Hallelujah.
Doctor. I have a right to go to church. I have a right to remain disciplined. I have a right to community outings. I have a right to talk. I have a right to education. I have a right to refuse treatment. I have a right to privacy and dignity. I have a right to make money. I have a right to exercise. I have a right to see my records. I have a right to own possessions. I have a right to own possessions. I have a right to receive services. I have a right to no discrimination. I have a right to know this law.
we'll be learning more about Groundhog Day. Groundhog Day is celebrated annually on February 2nd. On this day, people use a groundhog to determine the length of the current winter season and the possible early onset of spring. This weather prediction is dependent on the day's conditions. 6 more weeks of winter are on the way if sunshine causes the groundhog to see its shadow and go back into hibernation.
Sorry, folks! 6 more weeks of winter.
While clouds and gray skies prevent the appearance of the groundhog's shadow and result in spring's speedy arrival. The period between the winter solstice and spring equinox has been important throughout history. For instance, the Celts anticipated spring by celebrating the pagan festival of Imolc. Some people believe Imolc then evolved into the Christian holiday of Candlemas, which celebrates the presentation of Jesus at the temple and falls on the 2nd of February. It was during the Middle Ages that Europeans began to rely on the shadows of hibernating animals as an indication of incoming weather. During the 1700s and 1800s, German immigrants brought this belief to the United States and selected the groundhog as the chosen animal in Pennsylvania. The first official celebration of Groundhog Day occurred in that state's city of Punxsutawney in the late 1880s, when several businessmen and groundhog hunters of the Punxsutawney Groundhog Club watched the groundhog observing his shadow. Though this holiday has since spread across North America, the biggest annual Groundhog Day celebrations remain in its place of origin, where a groundhog dubbed Punxsutawney Phil predicts the weather. Tens of thousands of people and countless media outlets visit the city during early February to participate in festivities that include music and food. For the actual ceremony, Phil is relocated to Gobbler's Knob by his handlers, made up of a group of top hat and tuxedo-wearing individuals called the Inner Circle. Though the Punxsutawney Groundhog Club maintains that Phil is right up to 90% of the time, studies have shown the number is actually closer to less than 40%. This has done nothing to quell people's interest and fascination with the groundhog's forecasts. In fact, the holiday was given an even bigger boost following the successful 1993 comedy Groundhog Day.
This is one time where television really fails to capture the true excitement of a large squirrel predicting the weather.
Set in Punxsutawney, the film also led to Groundhog Day being used as an expression for experiencing situations over and over again.
Do you ever have deja vu, Mrs. Lancaster?
I don't think so, but I could check with the kitchen.
From movies and TV shows to children's toys, Phil and Groundhog Day have appeared in pop culture on numerous occasions. Though Groundhog Day is mostly observed in North America, other countries practice similar traditions. Some American states use other animals instead of the groundhog. Meanwhile, the Canadian city of Wyarton in Ontario is home to a popular festival based around a groundhog named Wyarton Willie. For more great videos, be sure to... Thank you.
Hello, my name is Kamala Harris, and excuse me, I am speaking. My whole name is Kamala Davy Harris, and I was born in Oakland, California on October 20th, 1964. I am an American politician and an attorney and your Vice President of the United States. I am the first female and woman of color that has occupied the White House as Vice President. I am Black and Asian American. I was the 27th District Attorney of San Francisco for 7 years. Then I became the 32nd Attorney General of California for 6 years. And then after an election, I was elected a United States Senator from California for 4 years. And that experience prepared me to become the first woman vice president. I went to Howard University in Washington, D.C., and I am a soror in the Alpha Kappa Alpha sorority. By the way, my mother is from India, and my dad is from Jamaica. Are there any questions? I was born on October 20th. In Oakland, California, 1964. I was bused to Thousand Oaks Elementary School, which was in its second year of integration. I lived in a predominantly Black, lower middle class neighborhood, and I had to travel to a prosperous white district. I attended middle school and high school in Montreal, Canada, because my mother got a better job as a teacher and a cancer researcher. In Montreal, my sister Maya and I led a peaceful demonstration at my apartment building in order to get a policy change that banned children from playing on the lawn. I was 13. I majored in political science as an undergrad at Howard University, and when I attended law school, it was in San Francisco. Next question. In 1990, I joined the Alameda County Prosecutor's Office in Oakland. Most of my cases were for sex crimes. Although my family was skeptical at first of me being a prosecutor, I wanted to change the system from the inside out. Next question. Yes, I am married to Doug Inhofe, a corporate lawyer in Los Angeles. In 2014, we got married. My sister was the minister that married us, I became a stepmother to two of his wonderful, beautiful children who call me Mamala. That will be all for today. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Español a Rayfield. Good day and welcome to Spanish class at Rayfield. Are you guys all ready? You're pumped? You learned so much so far and you're just going stronger and stronger. We're going to learn more and more. And I'm glad to see you all here. So hopefully you enjoy a little bit of music that we play before class actually starts. I do it for your enjoyment and mine as well. I love this pasito. Anyway, Español a refil, lección 11, los números del 0 al 100. Okay. Spanish at Rayfield, lesson 11, lección, say that with me, lección, lección, once, 11, once, lección, once, los números del cero al cien, the numbers from 0 to 100. Now, it's not going to be as tough as you think. It's going to go smoothly. And of course, I mean, you know the numbers in English, 1 through 100. So there's no reason you can't learn them in Spanish. And we'll start off with, what is that? Who can pronounce that for me? It's almost the same in English. It looks like this. Correct. Cero. Cero. Zero in Spanish is cero. That was easy. So, we start with cero. I'm going to just go through you with you quickly, and then we're going to do them one at a time. Cero. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, y diez. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, y 10. So, what did I just do? What did I just count? That's right. From 0 to 10 in Spanish. So now let's start together and let's try to pronounce. Cero. Cero. Uno. Uno. Dos. Dos. Tres. Tres. Cuatro. Cuatro. Cinco. Cinco. Seis. Seis. Siete. Siete. Ocho. Ocho. Nueve. Nueve. Diez. Diez. Okay. Now, together.
On the count of three.
One, two, three. Uno. One more time. Uno. Dos. One more time. Dos. Tres. Tres. Cuatro. Are you doing it with me? Cuatro. I want to hear you louder. Cinco. Cinco. Seis. Seis. Siete. Siete. Ocho. Ocho. Nueve. Nueve. Diez. Diez. Excellent. Now we're going to go run right through them all together. Okay? From 0 to 10. Let's do it together. You're pumped. Take a breath. You guys got your notebooks and your pens. All right? Well, let's start. Cero. Uno. Dos. Tres. Cuatro. Cinco. Seis. Siete. Ocho. Nueve. Diez. Again. That was good. Again. Cero. Uno. Dos. Tres. Cuatro. Cinco. Seis. Siete. Ocho. Nueve. Y diez. Awesome, guys. Awesome. You know what? I like the way that sounded. Let's do it one more time. I'm not even going to point. You can do it. We'll start with zero on the count of three. One, two, three. Cero. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, y diez. Bravo. Okay. We'll review, don't worry. But now we're going to pass on to what comes out after 10, huh? Who can tell me what comes after 10? Mm-hmm. Yep. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Okay. So we did the single column. Now we'll do the double column. All right. So 11. Once. Once. With me on three. One, two, three. Once. Once. Okay. Next. Doce. Doce. Let me hear you a little louder. Doce. Trece. Trece. You following the rhythm here? Once. Dos. Doce. Tres. Trece. Catorce. Catorce. With me one more time. Catorce. Quince. Quince. Quince is a very important number in Spanish, you know. Quince means what? 15. Correct. Now, you know how here in America we celebrate a sweet 16 for the girls. Well, in this Latin countries, they celebrate 15 years old. They celebrate quince. So you might hear people talking about, we're going to have my quince this year. And in English or in America, we say, we're going to have our sweet 16. So now you know, Latin people celebrate quince, their 15th birthday. Quince. One more time with me. Quince. Okay. So we got up to 15 now. it starts to change how we say it. But it's the same in English. You know, we say 11, we say 12, then it changes. Then we add the team part to it. Excuse me. Then we say, after 12, we say 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Okay? Well, Spanish, we do something similar. We have 11, 12, and 13, oh, and 14, and 15. Then it changes. Then we add what? We add the 10 to it like we do in English. Teen. Teen means 10 in English too, you know. We say 13, 14. So here we say the 10 first. Dieciséis. Dieciséis. Say it with me. Dieciséis. Okay, that was 16. Now look at 17. Diecisiete. Diecisiete. See the 10? Dieci plus siete. Here was dieci plus seis. Diecisiete. With me? Diecisiete. Correcto. Dieciocho. 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 One more time. Dieciocho. Diecinueve, the last teen. Diecinueve. Let me hear you. Diecinueve. Claro. And finally, veinte. Veinte, that's 20. So, you just did the teens. We're going to do it again. Repeat it with me. Okay, on the count of three. One, two, three. 11 is once. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, now let's do it. You do it all together. We'll go a little slow. We'll repeat them twice. Okay? 11, 11, 12, 12, 13, 13. 14, 14, 15, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Bravo, bravo. We'll run through them a little more rapidly now. Together on three. 1, 2, 3. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, where is 15, you remember? 15, it's 15, and what's so special about it? The girls in Latin America celebrate that as a big birthday, their 15th birthday, their 15, remember that, 15. Okay. 17, 17, 18, 18, 19, 19, 20. From the top again on three. 1, 2, 3. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. One more time. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18. 19, 20, 20. Bravo. Very good, guys. I'm very proud of you. Okay, so now we've got from 1 to 20. We got that down pat. It's pretty good. We're going to try something now. Let's see if we can get to 100. We don't have to repeat every single number. We get to 100. It's like in English, you know, we'll count from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we go 20, then we do the teens. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Then we could just say, we know it's 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. And that doesn't change because we go to the next. So we know 20 is 20. So we go on to 30. 30. From 30, we go to 40. Okay? 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. So what did we do? We just did the tens column. Okay? We did 10, 10, 20, 30. Now notice how you say 30, because there's an I there. You don't just say 30. You have to include the sound of the I. So it's 30, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Very good. I'm going to slow down. I just wanted you to hear the rhythm. Okay? So we'll go back and do the tens column. We're going to repeat it twice. I want you to do it with me, okay? So we'll start with 10. Yes. And what's the next one? I'll repeat it. Yes. Yes. And go on to the next one. 20 is 20. 20. It also has the I, so we have to include it. 20. 20. 30. 30. 40. 40. 50. 50. 60. 60. 70, 70, 80, 80, 90, 90. And finally, finalmente, 100. Who knows what 100 is? Who can tell me? Very good. 100 is 100. Very good. So, look what you accomplished. There are some things that change. I'm going to talk to you about them. But, you know, you can actually count now from 0 to 100. Del 100, del 0 al 100, okay? Del 0 al 100. So, let's return just for a quick review. Instead, I'm going to give you something a little bit more complicated. So, let's start with the one column. We start with, what's this? Who's going to tell me? Okay, louder. Correct. Zero. Zero. All right, we say zero, they say zero. What's the big deal? You can remember that. Zero. Uno. Uno. Dos. Dos. Louder, I can't hear you. A little louder. Tres. Tres. Cuatro. Cuatro. Cinco. Cinco. Ah, now there's another number you guys should be familiar with. Every May 5th, there is a celebration. Okay? The celebration of May 5th, especially in Mexico. In Mexico, it's called El Cinco de Mayo. El Cinco de Mayo. The 5th of May. Big holiday celebration. Okay? So it's not their independence. It's a celebration of a little battle that was won on the 5th of May. But nonetheless, it's a big celebration in Mexico. So, cinco, seis, siete. With me, a little louder. Cinco, seis, seis, siete, siete, ocho, ocho, nueve, nueve, diez. Yes. Now, remember the Z is not like a Z in English. It's not diez. It's yes, almost like a C or S. Yes. Okay? Let me hear you say ten. Yes. Yes. Okay, bueno. Cero. Let's go through it rapidly a couple of times. I want this to be embedded in your mind because these are the most simple numbers. These are the numbers you're going to be using. Okay. So, cero. Oh, you ready? I'm sorry. On the count of three. One, two, three. We'll do it two or three times. Cero, uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Again, from the top. Cero, uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. One more time. I love the way you say it. Your pronunciation is very good. From the top, we start with zero on a count of three. One, two, three. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, y diez. Bravo, bravo. Okay. Now, we got that down pat. Let's see if we can rapidly go through the teens column, okay? Remember what I taught you about that. So, we'll start with 11, okay? Once, twice, with me. Once, once, doce, doce, trece, trece, catorce, catorce, quince, quince. Now it changes. Dieciséis, dieciséis, diecisiete, diecisiete, dieciocho, dieciocho, diecinueve, diecinueve, veinte, veinte. Bravo. Now we'll do the same thing as we did in the ones column. We're going to run through them a couple of times straight. Okay, it's embedded in our mind. Get the rhythm, okay, like a poem, okay, like a song. I'm gonna get it in there. So we'll start on the count of three, and we'll do it about three times, all right? So, ready? Uno, dos, tres. Once, doce, trece, catorce, quince, dieciséis, diecisiete, dieciocho, diecinueve, veinte. Once, doce, trece, catorce, quince, dieciséis, diecisiete, dieciocho, diecinueve, veinte. Once, doce, trece, catorce, quince, dieciséis, diecisiete, dieciocho, diecinueve, veinte. Awesome. Awesome. You guys thrill me. I love it. Okay. Now we're going to do the same thing, try to get that embedded in our minds, the tens column, okay? Repeat everything by multiples of 10. And we'll start from 10 and get to 100, okay? Del 10 al 100. Okay? Let's do it a couple of times, repeating each one twice. And then we'll do our rapid flow. So, diez, diez, veinte, veinte, treinta, treinta. Try and get those sounds, the EI. Treinta, treinta, cuarenta, cuarenta, cincuenta, cincuenta, sesenta, sesenta. 70, 70, 80, 80, 90, 90, 100, 100. Very good. Okay. Now we'll do the running through it kind of smoothly like we did the others. Let's do it three times again so we get to hear the sounds fluidly in our mind like music. Like a song, help you remember the sounds and remember the pronunciation. Okay, so on the count of three, and we'll do it three times. Uno, dos, tres. Diez, veinte, treinta, cuarenta, cincuenta, sesenta, setenta, ochenta, noventa, cien. Repete. Diez. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Una vez más, one more time. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Very good, guys. Awesome. Awesome. You just learned how to count from 0 to 100. Almost. I have to throw in the monkey wrench. Almost. Because actually, there are some changes that take place when we start to say, like, from 20, you count from 20 to 30 and 30 to 40, etc., etc. And in English, it's pretty simple. It's, you know, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Then 30 is the same. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40 the same. 41, 42, 43, 44, and so on and so forth, all the way till the end. In Spanish, better don't. It's a little difference. I want to get something. Hold on. Okay, I wanted to get a note that I have to make sure that I impart this information to you correctly. Okay, plus I had to get a drink of water because I was coughing, excuse me. So as I was saying, there are little differences, okay? We'll say, taking the 20 numbers, okay? 20, 21. I'm gonna write that. Let me get my bag. Okay, now it changes a little bit. 21. Okay, and it pretty much does the same. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. 28, 29, 30. Okay. So it's the same in English. You just put the 20 plus the number 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth. Okay. However, when you get into the 30s, there's a slight difference. Okay. Slight difference. This is kind of smooth. 21. But when we get to the 30s, okay. We're going to say 30, 30, and now here's where the change comes. E, uno. See that? See the difference? This was smooth, 21. Now it's 31, 31, 30 plus 1. That's how we would translate it in English. Normally, in English, though, we do all numbers 21, 31, 32. Changes in Spanish. After you have 21, which is 21, then it becomes 30 plus 1. 30 and 1. Remember, what does E mean? E means and. So, 31. 32. 30. Y cuatro, 35, 36, 37, 38, 40, 39, 40, claro. Okay. Excuse me. That's a sign I talk too much, see? God makes me cough when I talk too much, see? That's good for my wife. It's a sign for me to shut up, so. But I apologize because it's not time for me to shut up with you guys. I got a lot more work to do. Almost, not a lot. You guys are really doing great. And I really appreciate your attention here. So, I showed you the difference when you skip from 20, the 20s to the next number, to the 30s. Okay? And that continues on all the way through 90. So we would say 41 for 41. 41. Can you say that with me? 41. Good. Now, what's the next one? 50, correcto? So how do you say 51? 51. 52, 53. Okay? So you got the idea, you got the rhythm. Ahora, 60. 61. 61. Say it with me. 61. 62. So, what do you think is going to happen when we get to 70? 70. 71. 72. 73. Correcto. Now we go to 80. 81. 82. Say it with me.
Don't
81. 82. Now, the final one is 90. 90. 90, you say first. I'm not going to tell you. Let me hear. Say it. How do you say 91? 91. Great. 91. 92. 93. So, you guys got it. It just changes. 20, it's 21. 22. From 30, 31. 41. 42. Okay? So, guys, you're awesome. You got that. Hope you took your notes. Practice this. You can go on to Rayfield's YouTube channel to repeat it if you want to study a little bit more on your own. Okay? Again, forgive me for this cough, but I appreciate your company. I appreciate your patience. I appreciate your diligence. And I guess we'll see you next time, okay? Hasta la vista. Actually, I'm going to see you tomorrow, won't I? What's tomorrow? The virtual tour, correct. And the theme is love yourself. So, hasta mañana. See you tomorrow. Hasta mañana. Say it. Hasta mañana. Chao, estudiantes. Have a good day. Love you all.
Good afternoon. Hello. Hi, team. How are you? Today, I will be speaking with you on one of the Bill of Rights. And that Bill of Rights is you have the right to work. And you have the right to make money. By working, it will shape your world. There are so many disability people that want to work, but some of you guys are scared to take that first step. Don't be limited because you have disabilities. We have people that are doctors. We have people that are lawyers. We have all kind of people out there with disabilities. But do you think they let disability stop them? No. No. They was not limited to their disability. They kept pushing, and they kept pushing till they did what they wanted to do in life. So, guys, let's make the impossible possible, because all things are possible. all things are possible. When we begin to work, work can shape our life. It can make us have a better life. We can make our own money. We can buy things that we really need. There is 10 and 10,000 of disability people who want to work, who have disabilities. But disability, it don't limit you. Don't let it limit you. You have the right to work. You have the right to make money. If you have a supportive employee, it plays a big part in your working environment. When you have someone that will work with you, they'll be patient with you. They will train you. Man, you can begin to work and you can begin to earn your money because by that employee being supportive to you, it gives you more confidence in yourself. There are many jobs out there for disabilities with autism and other disabilities. When you go to apply for a job, I want you to remember this. Ladies, dress for success. Dress in a nice dress or in nice slacks in a nice blouse with it. No short dresses, no revealing clothing. No shorts, no tank tops. Clothes should be clean and ironed. You should wear shoes, nice shoes. Young men, wear nice slacks, no jeans. Wear a nice shirt, no shorts. And tank tops, don't wear no sneakers. Wear dress shoes. Yes, go dress to impress. Dressing as if you are looking for a job. Searching for a job that you think that you like, that you can do, a job that you can be trained on. Anybody can be trained. If you pay attention to what someone is doing, you will be trained for that job. And soon, you will be working on your own. And as I said before, if you have a supportive employee or supervisor, the more they work with you and if they have patience with you, you can be trained. And when they train you, it gives you so much confidence in yourself when they are patient with you. So when you go in with an application completely filled out. Present a resume and dress for success. So when you go out, I'm saying good luck to you. Don't let disability limit you. Don't let a disability hold you down. You may not be able to do what one person do, but God has given you something inside of you that you can do. You can do anything you put your mind to and focus on. Don't be limited by disability. Don't let disability limit you. Reach for the sky, guys. Because you can do anything that you really put your mind to. This is October at Rayfield. This month, all things are possible. All things are possible. Just believe it and receive it.